So I'm back with the same concentrates from the last video. Do you remember we soaked it in vinegar for 5 days and got more gold out of it? So here's the story. I picked up these concentrates about, I don't know, a week and a half ago. And I ran it through the Gold Fox Mini Monster and got some gold. It was great. And I thought I got all the gold. Then I decided, well, why not take those concentrates and soak them in vinegar for 5 days, which I did. And then I ran it through the VDR Mini Sluice, and I ran it through the Micro Gold Cleanup Sluice from Flower Gold Wizards, and more gold. Not much. So some gold was released with the vinegar. So I thought, why not take the same concentrates and let them soak in hydrogen peroxide? Because I heard people say that if you let it soak in hydrogen peroxide, more gold will be released from this black sand. But I think we got all the gold. I mean, we did. I'm sure of it. But anyways, I'm going to run the test anyways. So I poured the hydrogen peroxide in the bucket. It's been sitting there for 3 days, bubbling. Now, will that release even more gold? Let's find out.
Hydrogen peroxide.
When you do this, keep this outside, not inside. There's our six sizes, smallest to largest, left to right.
We're gonna start with the VDR Mini Sluice and run the finest materials through that.
First thing is get the bubbles out. So that is all the finest materials. Let it run for a second, and we'll do a clean out. That's a nice black sand in there. It's a lot less concentrate, and they're all the same size, so it'll pan out pretty fast.
Any of you honestly believe there's going to be any gold in there? After all the times and all the micro sluices, and vinegar and all that we've run it through and got the gold. Okay, I'm sniffing that up. Next size. Remember what I said. We're waiting for these to get half full, and these to get half full. We don't want any more full than that. If they're full, they're not going to be able to spin like this, or like that. When they move around like that, that's where the gold's released. The light is not good enough to see if I have any gold in there. We'll just have to do a clean out and check it in a better light. The more of that black sand that goes down, the less work I have to do. Still a pretty darn easy cleanup. Everyone's on. Now I can turn it off. A lot less
Life sand. Make it much easier to pan out.
Shake it down. You can see when you shake it, the lights come up and move to the back area. You just make them easier to fall right out. You see? Okay. Shake up a little bit more. More of the lights. You can't see it, but I can see a little bit of really light powder right there, like flour. I'm just gonna go ahead and take this little bit right here, what's left, and we'll just snuffer that up. We'll use the small pan. Right, that's our concentrates. What I'm going to do is just real slow, and then I won't make you guys watch all of it. Pretty much I'm just going to shake it, bring back a little bit, shake it some more, and bring back a little bit. It's going to take about 10 minutes, so be right back. Down to the last few bits. Not seen a lot. So here's what we got overall from the three sizes that we did. And I can see some gold right there coming out. I'll zoom up on it so you can see it. It's right there. It's jumping out like a little light bulb. So see a good size flake there, really. And a bunch of micro dots. So let's go ahead and let's dry it out. See how it looks under the macro lens. The microscope, same thing.